Welcome to Top Scholars. We know that Asia, the largest continent, is home to majestic and expansive rivers shaped by landscapes, cultures, and civilizations for millennia. In this video, let us explore the top 10 longest rivers in Asia, each with unique characteristics and significance, highlighting their significance in shaping the region. Do you know that Asia is home to some of the world's longest rivers, including the Yangtze, Yellow, and Ob rivers? So, let's know about the largest river in Asia, which is the Yangtze River. The Yangtze River is the largest in Asia and the third longest in the world. It spans 3,915 miles, that is 6,300 kilometers, from the plateau of Tibet to the East China Sea. Starting in the plateau of Tibet, it passes through 11 provinces and serves as the border for several. Over 75% of the river runs through mountains. The Yangtze River, also known as the cradle of Chinese civilization, has been home to communities for thousands of years, serving as a vital transportation, agriculture, and industry route. The second largest river of Asia is the Yellow River. The Yellow River, also known as Huanghe, is a 3,395 mile long river in China that begins in Kangi province, crosses six other provinces, and empties into the Bohai Sea in Shandong province. The Yellow River is considered the mother river of China, nurturing the country's history and culture. The basin was the most prosperous region in Chinese history during ancient times. The river's alluvial plains are conducive to planting and wildlife habitats. Now, let's know about the Mekong River. The Mekong River, the longest Southeast Asian river, is 4,909 kilometers, flows through various borders from southeastern China to Myanmar, Laos, Thailand, Cambodia, and Vietnam, draining into the South China Sea. Its name varies, but it is most recognized outside Asia by its Chinese name. The river's navigation capacity is inadequate due to changes in flow during dry and rainy seasons and the presence of torrents and waterfalls. Despite being navigable for only 550 kilometers downstream, the Mekong remains an essential trade route for China and Southeast Asian countries. The river's main section, Lekang Jiang, flows into the Indochina Peninsula. The next river is Lena River, which is the fourth largest river of Asia. The Lena River, spanning 2,668 miles, that is 4,294 kilometers, is located within Russia's border and is surrounded by abundant wildlife and natural resources, including gold. It begins in the Baikal Range and flows through the Russian Republic of Sakha, joining the Yenisei River before ending in the Laptev Sea, part of the Arctic Ocean. Next is the Irtysh River, the fifth longest waterway in Asia, which originates from the glaciers in the Altai Mountains of Xinjiang Province, China. It flows westward across China, Kazakhstan, and Russia before reaching the Ob River in western Siberia. The river spans 2,640 miles, that is 4,248 kilometers, and crosses into Russia before reaching the Ob River in western Siberia. Next is the Brahmaputra River, spans through 2,391 miles, that is 3,848 kilometers, and flows through China, India, and Bangladesh. It originates in the Himalayas and flows east through the Tibet Autonomous Region, India, and the Ganges River. It converges with the Ganges in the Bay of Bengal and passes through Assam and Bangladesh. It is vital for agriculture, fisheries, and transportation, supporting millions of people relying on its water for irrigation and livelihood. The seventh largest is the Ob River. The Ob River spans 2,268 miles and is entirely located in Russia. It is a significant transportation route in Russia, particularly in the central region. It flows north and west across western Siberia, forming a corkscrew from the Altai Mountains to the Gulf of Ob before heading north into the Arctic Ocean. The next is the Indus River. The Indus River is around 2,243 miles, that is 3,610 kilometers, and is the largest and the most important river in Pakistan, passing through China, India and Pakistan. It starts from the Tibetan Plateau near Lake Manasarovar and Himalayas, run through Jammu and Kashmir and flows south through Pakistan before ending into the Arabian Sea, a part of the Indian Ocean. The Indus River is vital for Pakistan's agriculture, industry and hydropower generation, supporting millions of people whose livelihoods depend on its water for irrigation and drinking. It is also home to ancient civilizations like the Harappan civilization. The next largest river of Asia is the Yenisei River, spanning 2,167 miles, that is 3,487 kilometers, is the largest river system flowing into the Arctic Ocean. It originates in the Northern Mongolia and flows north through Russia to the Kara Sea. The upper reaches are sparsely populated due to rapids and flooding, while the middle section is controlled by hydroelectric dams. The Yenisei River is a vital lifeline for Siberia's people and ecosystem and a vital source of hydroelectric power generation, with several dams built along its course contributing significantly to Russia's energy production and supply. And lastly, the Nizhnyaya Tunguska River, a 1,857 mile long waterway in western Siberia, flows east of the Yenisei River as a major tributary, passing through Irkutsk province and the Krasnoyarsk region. Originating in the eastern Sayan Mountains, it flows through a sparsely populated region of Siberia before merging with the Yenisei River. The river features a broad valley with numerous sandbanks, as well as gorges and rapids. The river's name, Nizhnya Tunguska, distinguishes it from the separate Upper Tunguska River. The river's length is a testament to its natural beauty and diverse ecosystem. So, now let's try to answer some questions. Question 1. What is the Yellow River also known as? Question 2. From where does the Yenisei River originate? Question 3. Why is River Mekong navigation inadequate? Question 4. Where is Ob River located? Question 5. From where does Lena River originate? With this, we have come to an end of this video. We hope you learned something new and interesting. For more such interesting and knowledgeable videos, do follow us. Thank you and happy learning.